Hello, I'm Gavin Hoey and you're watching another Photoshop tutorial. Now in the past I've done some great techniques and ended up putting the images onto an abstract background, and I've had so many requests from people saying, how do you make the abstract background? Well, I'm going to show you how to do it, and it's really, really simple. Now, you either want to start with a picture you want to put the background on, or in my case, I'm going to start with a blank document. So let's go to File, choose New, and I'm going to make an A4 landscape image. There we go, so a blank document. Now these abstract backgrounds are created just using one tool, and that's the gradient tool. So we'll find the gradient tool on the toolbar, but we need to do a little bit of setting up for this to work. So along the options bar here, first of all, let's click the drop down arrow and make sure that we're working on the foreground to background color, and that's the one in the top left corner. Next, we need to choose the type of gradient. And the one I'm going to use is the normal linear gradient, which is again the first one on your little list along the options bar. Now the important thing that we really want to choose is the mode. This is where the magic happens. So currently the mode is set to normal, which is where you would normally leave it. I'm going to click on the drop down list and I'm going to choose difference. Now this is where things get interesting, because what you need to do is to start drawing some gradients. Oh, I should have said colors. I've got a red and a green, but really what I want is black and white. So let's just click the little black and white squares and reset my colors back to black and white. Okay, so with the gradient tool, all I'm going to do is click in the bottom left corner and drag up towards the top right and let go, and I get a perfectly normal looking gradient. But if I go in the other direction, so now start in the bottom right corner and click and drag up to the top left, I'll get a gradient that looks like this. Now the process is dead simple. Basically repeat those steps, one corner to the other and then in the opposite direction. So you make these zigzag gradients like so. Now, you don't always have to go from corner to corner. You can have little short ones, like so. And they don't always have to be accurate. They can always be sort of up and down or left and right. In fact, sometimes it's best to just change the angle and come up with all sorts of different ones, like so. And as you can see, as I do this, I start to build up a pattern. Every time I drag a gradient on, the pattern changes slightly. So you have to be watching. You have to look out for a time when you see the pattern that you like. Okay, this can take a while, but let's say I like that one. Now that's great, but what about a colour? Black and white's okay, but it's a little bit dull. Well, if you want to add a dash of colour in there, change your foreground colour from black and choose something more exciting. Let's go for a bright red. I'm just going to add a dash across in bright red and then in the other direction in bright red, like that. And I get this kind of red-blue thing going on, a lot more brighter colour. If you want a really vivid colour scheme, change to a different colour. Let's choose a blue, for example, and repeat those steps. So I'll put a blue across, and now you can see I've got some really vivid colours. Now, the really nice thing about this technique is if you do see something that you like and it was a couple of clicks back, you can go back and find it, because this is all undoable as far as your history will go. So let's go backwards. Edit, step backwards, edit, step backwards, edit, step backwards, edit, step backwards. I want to go back to the black and white. There we go. So I've got a black and white one, but what if I want a subtle, gentle tone, which is the way I prefer to have these? Well, we do that by going to Image, Adjustments, and Hue Saturation. Now, the Hue Saturation has a nice little button called Colorize. So let's put a click inside of Colorize. There we go. And we can start to colorize this image. We can start to add some color in. So if I move the Hue slider, you'll see that the color shifts as I move my Hue slider along. Now, if you want a stronger, more vivid color, push the saturation slider up and you'll get a much more vivid color. Again, you can change the hue to anything you like, but sometimes I find these blacks a little bit too deep. In that case, I can get the lightness slider, and this is one of the very few times I actually use this lightness slider. And I can move it towards the left, the right-hand side, and all those blacks will fade away. Similarly, if I think it's a bit too bright, I can move the lightness down to the left-hand side and it all gets nice and dark. So there's all these different effects in here simply by moving these sliders around. Okay, so there we go. That's fine. Color-wise, I think that's perhaps a little bit strong. Let's just grab a more subtle kind of browny color. That looks good. Now, another thing you can do is to take away these really sharp edges by putting a bit of a Gaussian blur. Filter, blur, Gaussian blur, and just blurring these up a little bit. It doesn't have to be too much. Anything between 5 and 10 tends to look pretty good. But once you're happy, there you have it. You now have your very own abstract background. So all you need to do now is just find a picture, create a picture of your choice, and drag and drop it on. There we go. And we now have a great looking background for an abstract effect.